Okay, we're going to talk about normal distribution, and we're going to focus on these two equations to begin with. And the first thing we need to do is we need to calculate the mean and the standard deviation with this information. So n equals the number of trials. And p equals the probability. Okay, now in class, I pick each person in your group to pick a different drug to do calculations for. And we're trying to figure out, this right here shows the mean minus one standard deviation and the mean plus one standard deviation. So I'm going to do example number four, and other students will have done examples one and two, and this is just to demonstrate where we're headed. So with example four, you know that the that p equals 20%, so 0.2, and you know that n equals 400. So we're going to use this information. So to find the mean is 400 times 0.2, right? The number of trials times the percentage. And so we multiply that together and we get 80. And then we also, to find the standard deviation, we take the square root of NP, which we just found out was 80, and then 1 minus 0.2. Okay, so this gives me 80 times 0.8, which gives me the square root of 64, and so my standard deviation is equal to 8. So I'm going to use these two things in order to calculate our probability. So the mean minus the standard deviation. So 80 minus 8 gives me 72. And 80 plus the standard deviation, so the mean plus the standard deviation, is going to give me 88. So I want to find the probability of getting between 72 and 88. Okay, so in my calculator, I'm going to do binome CDF. Number of trials is 400. Probability is 0.2. And the x value here, the number of trials is going to be, we're going to do 88. And that's going to give me, so here's the probability of out of 400 trials, 88 trials is there, and then we're going to figure out the probability of 72 trials, which is everything less than here. And when I subtract the two, I'm going to end up between 72 and 88. Okay, and this is going to give me the probability between one standard deviation below and one standard deviation above our mean, and our mean which is 80. Okay, so I put this into my calculator and I get 0.8557, and then I do binome CDF 400 0.2 and 77. Just for those who aren't sure what I'm talking about, if you haven't seen an earlier lesson, what did we do? We hit second var, we arrowed down to binome CDF, I hit enter, number of trials is 400, percent probability of success is 0.2, and the value that we're dealing with is 72. I hit enter, and I get 0.01746. and then I subtract the two in order to find this, and I get 0.8557 minus 0.1746, and then I get 0.6811. Okay, so this is the probability of being one standard deviation below and one standard deviation above the mean and in between here. Okay, now if you check your data with your partners, you end up getting this data. You might want to hit pause if you want to get your check your answers. But the thing I want you to drive home is, now this data is small because we had a very small number of trials. When you look here, we had 20, our n was 20, and our n was 38. Once we had a lot more number trials, it increased our accuracy of what we're doing. And the thing that I want you to notice is, if I go one standard deviation above and one standard deviation below, we will always have about 68.26% between one standard deviation below and one standard deviation above the mean, no matter what the percentage of success or what the mean is. So in the example number four, we had 68.11% and 67.36%. Okay, now the difference here is I was dealing with a binomial distribution, because in here we were using discrete data with number of trial patients. Now with normal distribution, we're going to be dealing with things that are measured. So so you're going to measure things like time with a clock, or measuring length with centimeters or something like that. So you'll want to read this page here, which talks about normal distribution. And basically we're going to talk about the importance of one standard deviation away or multiple standard deviations away, which is kind of summarized in here. So if I go one standard deviation below to the mean, it's going to be this percentage. If I go two standard deviations above the mean, then this value between one standard deviation and this is 13.569%. Okay, so let's do an example. Okay, they've told you that the mean is 95 centimeters. So the very first thing I did when I drew on my curve is I put 95 right there in the center on all of these. Okay, now we know the standard deviation is 8. So because the standard deviation is 8, I'm going to increase this by 8. So if I add 8 to 95, I have 103. If I add 8 to this, I get 111. If I subtract 8 from here, I get 87. And if I subtract 8 from that, I get 79. And then we look at what we have right here. And we're told we want to find the percentage between 87 and 103. So I find 87 is right here, which is one standard deviation below, and 103, which is one standard deviation above. So these two, the probability between here and here is going to, we're going to add these two together, and we get the probability of being in this space right here is 68.26%. Okay. And from this one here, so now we want to find the percentage of football players with a chest measurement between 103 and 111 centimeters. So 103 centimeters is one standard deviation above the mean. 111 is two standard deviations above the mean. So then I can go back to this chart. Between one standard deviation and two standard deviations, we know that this amount is going to be 13.59%. Okay. We might also write this as 0.1359, right? Because that percentage is just moving the decimal two places. Okay. Next one here. Find the probability that the chest measurement is between 87 and 101. So 87 is 1 standard deviation below the mean, and 111 is 2 standard deviations above the mean. So I know this is 34.13, this is 34.13, and this is 13.59%. I add those all together and I get 81.85%. Now, this one is kind of working backwards. We say, okay, the value of K, such that approximately 16% of the chest measurements are below K. So, looking at the information, these two added together are approximately 16%. I know it's not exactly 16%, but these two added together are approximately 16%. So, since I know these two are together are approximately 16%, and we want to find the value of K that is below 16%, I know that this is 1 standard deviation below, and so the K value is 87. You might want to hit pause and replay that one if you have trouble with C. Okay, next one. So this is an important definition here. So explain why it is likely that the distribution of the following variables will be normal. So here we have volume, and here we have diameter. And the important thing, the reason that these are normal distributions is because things that are measurements rather than things that are counted. Whenever you have things that are measured, that is going to make it continuous. Whenever you have things that are counted, that makes them discrete. Okay? So things that are measured are things that are continuous. Okay, state the probability that the random normal distribution lies between a standard deviation below the mean and a standard deviation above the mean. So once again, we go to the chart. Here's 1 standard deviation below, 1 standard deviation above. In between there is 68.26%. Find the probability between the mean and 2 standard deviations above the mean. So that means we're starting at the mean, and we're going 2 standard deviations above the mean. So we're adding 34.13 plus 13.59 to get 47.72%. I'm going to drink some water. Okay, so next question. Okay, they've told you the mean is 184. So I just automatically put 184 at the mean right there in the center. Okay, now what's the likelihood of being taller than 189? So we know our standard deviation is 5 centimeters. So that means the distance between here and here is 5 centimeters. So I add 5 and I add 5. I subtract 5, I subtract 5. Okay, so now it says taller than 189. That means I go to 189 and I add those two, these all together. It's taller than 179. I go to 179 and I add all of these together. Between 174 and 199, I go to 174 and 199 and add all of these together. Over 199, I go right there, and I know that's 0.13. For all of these numbers come from our chart on the previous page. Now, in the next assignment after this, we won't need that chart because I'm going to show you how to do this on the calculator. Okay, question number 5. The mean is 48 millimeters, and the standard deviation is 6. So I go, so I write the standard deviations. So the higher one would be 54, and so on. We add 6 to subtract 6. And over a 20-year period, how many times would you expect the rain to be less than 42 millimeters? So I go down here, and I know there's my value there. And I figure out these percentages, it's 15.87%. Now, the question says, over a 20-year period. So I multiply that by 20, and then we're going to have 13.17 times over a 20-year period. We expect fall to be less than 42 millimeters. You might want to hit replay for that one if you have questions on that. Okay, next one. Same thing. All of these are the same. So we start off by the mean time is 10 minutes and 30 seconds. I put 10.5 because 30 seconds is half of a minute. I know that people had questions on how to do this. So the standard deviation is 15 seconds. So that's a quarter of a minute. So here I subtract 0.25. Here I add 0.25. Okay. And so took longer than 11 minutes. So add 0.25, add 0.25. That puts me in here. Okay. Took less than 10 and a quarter minutes. So that's, here's 10 and a quarter minutes. Okay. You may want to hit pause and check your work. Okay, I'm going to move this up. You may want to hit pause and check your work. Okay, last page. You may want to hit pause and check your work. And lastly, you may want to hit pause and check your answer.